Hey, what's up? This is Jimmy Brown, and welcome to another episode of the Capo Crusader. Today, I'm going to show you a very cool arrangement I came up with of the now classic Sublime song, Santeria, from their 1996 third album, self-titled Sublime. My arrangement has you playing the song with a capo at the fourth fret, and you're going to be playing it as if it's in the key of C. The original arrangement, Brad Knoll wrote the song in the key of E, and used a lot of bar chords and electric, kind of like that ska type of punk, you know, strumming. But this is much easier for an acoustic. And as you'll see, it allows you to do some neat open cowboy chords as well as bar chords. So I'm going to go through each part, I'll play it, and then I'll teach it to you. So here's my arrangement of the intro. Okay, so I'm playing a C chord, and I'm doing this kind of picky, strummy arpeggiation. Okay, down, 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 up, down, down. And then E7. I'm skipping over the fifth string, so I'm going sixth string. Down, 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 up. And then A minor, same thing, same kind of pattern. And then a little hammer on. Okay, and then the G. Letting all the notes ring. So what's neat about this part is that all the notes are ringing. You're taking advantage of the capo and with the, quote, open strings that it gives you. So you can do that too. You can add a little hammer on. Okay, that's going to give you a nice contrast to the verse section that kicks in, for which we're going to switch to all to bar chords for the sake of getting that nice tight dunk, chuck 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 chuck. Okay, so but at the end of the intro, I go on that G chord. And then we're into the verse. So let me show you the verse in its entirety, and then we'll go back and we'll break it down.
I don't practice Santeria, ain't got no crystal ball. Well, I had $1 million, but I spend it on a vodka, find that henna and that central that she's found. I pop a cap in central and I slap it down. All I really want to know, my baby, to say I can't define when it's love that I need. Yeah. My soul will have to wait till I get back, find a hand of my own that is gonna love one and all. And I feel the break, feel the break, feel the break. Got to live it up. Well, I swear that I, all I really want to know, my baby, what I really want to say, I can't define. That love makes this go, yeah. Well, my soul will have to.
Okay, I stopped there because that goes into the solo, which I'll show you next. So what we're doing is we're taking this, what is really, you could think of it as either an E chord, because if you look at it without the capo, it's an E bar chord. You know, 7th fret, index finger, and 9th fret with the pinky on the D, G, and B strings. But if you're thinking in terms of the capo, like this part doesn't exist here, it's a C chord, okay, relative to the capo. And you'll find that with the capo, it's a lot easier to press down on an acoustic guitar. You know, the capo effectively lowers the action. So, okay, you're kind of getting this like reggae type of strum where you hit the bass note first, and then kind of boom, chick, chick, chick. And then you're hitting the middle three notes of the chord. You don't want to hit the top string, you know, make sure you don't go, because that's just the wrong note to add that. So arch the pinky, or you may want to use a ring finger if some people have trouble with the pinky. Okay, so there's a couple things going on here. I'm going down, down, up, down. And I'm using fret hand muted, muted strumming. So it's kind of hard to see on camera here, but to get those, I'm just like, I'm squeezing when I want the chord to sound and then relaxing my grip when I don't want to sound. So I get the, see, now it doesn't matter what I do. My hand is not leaving the strings, but it's just not pressing them down. So I go. See, if I do that, it rings. If I go, it doesn't. So you want to get that feel. And then the next chord is relative to the capo, it's an E chord. What's cool is that you have this bass note here. The actual concert pitch chord is G sharp, but you think of it as, it's like a C shape. If you had like an open C chord, you know, you move it up to E relative to the capo. Okay, so you're going. Again, squeeze when you want the chord to sound, and then when you don't, you want to get that hollow percussive strum. And let the right hand should be nice and loose. I find it often helps to let the fingers be outstretched and just kind of drag across the pick guard. It's like a little, gives you a little sense of, you know, where you're at, like a tactile little feeler. Okay, now this is a F, G, F, F sharp, G, G sharp. It'd be an A minor chord relative to the capo, but it often gets a little confusing when you're getting away from the capo, you know, right? So the actual sounding concert pitch chord is C sharp minor, okay? So we got, relative to the capo, we got C major, E major, A minor. But if you want to, rather prefer to think in terms of absolute chords, concert pitch, it's E major, G sharp major, C sharp minor. I mean, you could do that without the capo, okay? Same techniques. Okay, that's G major relative to the capo, concert pitch B major. So the same thing is, I don't practice Santeria, I ain't got no crystal ball. I'm barring here, you could go get that top note. Well, I had $1 million, but I'd spend it all. So all that squeezing and releasing going there because you want that nice punctuated strum. And now we get to the chorus. This is the fun part where it really opens up and you get to use the open chords, open, you know, people call cowboy chords.
All I really want to know, my baby. Well, I really want to say I can't define, but it's love that I need. Well, my soul will have to.
And you're back into the bar chords again. So for the chorus, it's F. It's real easy to see when you're next to the capo, right? The actual concert pitch chord is A, and then you're doing this G shape relative to the capo, which is actually a B major chord. Capo makes it sound like a G voicing.
All I really want to know.
Okay, you could do like that, just real unmuted open strumming.
All I really want to know.
C, and then G over B. You know, or you could play it like this. And then A minor, and then G, F, G.
Really want to see.
G over B.
I can.
A minor, G, F. Keeps using the same chords. A really cool variation. If you want to get kind of fancy with the right hand, you can go.
All I really want to know, my baby.
Get a nice, quick, shimmering arpeggiation in there. And that's playing 16th notes in the middle four strings. Down, 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 up. Down, 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 up, down, 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 up. And then jumping over to the low E string for the bass note. So that's down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up. And it requires some nimble picking, you know, but if you practice it, you kind of see it coming and you get your right hand ready for it. Notice I have my pinky kind of anchored to the pick guard. It's almost, I think of it as like, you know, the foot that sticks out of a clam, that thing that sticks out. So it's kind of acting as a point of reference and stability.
I can't define.
You could also do what I call picky strummy style, which is where you're not being so precise with the single notes, and you know, you don't have to go. I mean, this is not a bluegrass flat picking contest here. You can go, you know, kind of like fake it, you know, you do alternate strumming.
Well, I really want to know, my baby. To say I can't define.
You do that too, really lay it down, right? Just quarter notes, boom, 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 and then vary it as you go. And then coming back into the verse.
Love I need, my soul will have to wait till I get back.
You may want to go to that G instead of the open G. It makes for a smoother transition.
My soul will have to wait till I get back. Find a head of my own that is gonna love one and all.
You notice most of the strums are muted. I'm actually hardly really hitting the chords. I'm hitting, making sure I pick the bass note at least once, like on the first time the chord hits on the first downbeat. You know, just selectively hitting that single note. You know, reggae has typically a very sparse bass line, right? Usually has some kind of like neat thing where there's a lot of rests involved and you have the chords and the drums doing all this like neat things between the cracks. Okay, next up, I'll play my little arrangement of the solo.
Well, my soul will have to.
Okay, so what I'm doing is kind of hinting at the melody, you know. You know, whoever he plays it in the open chords. Okay, so. Sorry. But you can be casual. You can include other notes in there. Because remember, the important thing is you got to keep the rhythm going. When you're playing solo, like a solo act, guitar, vocal, if you're going to go into a solo, it's got to be very rhythmic, you know. So you can just go to a full E chord there, or E7. You can get that in there. Okay, C. Just kind of like hammering on, you know, in the right rhythm to get that. And I'm actually targeting that bass note. And then it goes to A minor. That works good. And then, okay, and one more time. All right, I mean, you're doing a facsimile, you know, an approximation of it. You're relying on a familiarity with the solo already. You're just trying to get something that sounds more interesting than just playing the chords with nothing going on, right? Okay, then the second half. Working off the C shape. Okay, I'm starting on the G and B strings, but I'm using the high C note here as a pedal. Yeah, that'll pull off. You know, hinting at the melody. Again, I took it up an octave because originally he goes, you know. Right, that folk guy is in the G chord.
Ooh, yeah. All I really want to say, my baby.
So one more time, we'll do it real slow. Coming out of the chorus into the solo.
My soul will have to. My baby, what I really want to say is I've got mine, and I'll make it, oh yes, I'm going on the Sanchito, if he knows what's good for him, best go on and hide, daddy's got a new 45, and I won't think twice to stick that battle straight down Sancho's throat. Believe me when I say that I've got something for his punk ass. All I really want to know, my baby, what I really want to say is it's just one way back and I'll make it, yeah. My soul will have to wait.
What I did there at the end was was called a retard, where you just slow down.
And I'll make it, yeah. My soul will have to.
Slowing down.
Wait.
And then we ended on C7. Give it a little shimmering, a fake tremolo type of strum. And then rock and roll ending. Okay, remember, as is always the case when using a capo, you have that wonderful option of moving it down a couple frets or off the guitar altogether, depending on your vocal range preference. For example, you know, we're playing this capo 4, so we put it in the original key of E, original Sublime key, which sounds most familiar to most people's ears when you sing it in the original key. But say you want to take it down a half step, let's go capo 3. And then your verse chord, now it would be three frets up from the capo. So you can either think of it that way, or you can think of it as the actual sixth fret. And then you gotta get used to it. This is actually my pinky's at the 10th fret. That's the way I'm gonna think of it. Or you can think of it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You know, if you prefer to see it from the capo. Okay, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's your A minor shape, right? We went from, you know, it's transposing C is actually E flat now. E is actually G now. A minor is actually C minor. And then the G chord is actually B flat. You know, the closer you get to the capo, the more it's kind of familiar it's gonna look. So when you go to the chorus, no problem. Wherever you put the capo, you're gonna be able to go. Okay. Say if you want to take it down to second fret, you know, you have a deeper voice.
I don't practice Santeria, ain't got no silver ball. Well, I had $1 million, but I'd spend it all if I could.
You know, that's more of a, less of a high rock and roll, more of a baritone type of thing. So whatever key you want to sing it in, you have that wonderful option with the capo. And that's pretty much it. Have fun with it. I'm Jimmy Brown. I'll see you around on the next episode of the Capo Crusader.